Good evening, everyone, and thanks for joining us for our webinar tonight on pathways and entry options into UniSA. My name is Jen, and this is my colleague Amelia. We both work for UniSA supporting future students with their career and study options. So whether you've previously studied at a university, TAFE, or perhaps never studied before, there is a pathway option for everyone. In this presentation, we'll be going through all of the different pathway options, as well as some advice for how you can fit university into your life. Please note that we will be focusing on information for domestic Australian students. So if you're an international student, we would suggest getting in touch with our international team, and we'll include their contact details at the end of this presentation. So before we begin, the University of South Australia acknowledge that we are meeting on the land of the Kaurna people, and we pay our respect to elders past and present. This is an overview of what we're going to talk about this evening. You will find Elise ready in our Q&A to answer any questions as we go, but we would recommend watching the presentation first, as there will be a chance to ask questions at the end, and hopefully we'll cover your questions during the presentation. Well, let's see. So we thought we'd start with an introduction to UniSA and answer the question, why study with us? So we are Australia's leading young university for industry collaborations. We collaborate with over 2,500 companies worldwide. That includes the Adelaide Crows, BAE Systems, Rising Sun Pictures, and Qantas, just to name a few. This means our students are getting opportunities to work with and connect with industry throughout their degree through placements, internships, and projects. We are number one in Australia for graduate employability and number one in South Australia for graduate careers, which we've been able to hold for the past 16 years running. And that means our graduates have strong employment outcomes and are graduating career ready. And this is why they're so highly sought after amongst employers. Finally, once our students have completed their studies, we survey them and we ask questions around teaching quality, services, quality of their courses, and overall experience. And we find that we have the most satisfied students in the state. So we currently have over 37,000 students and they're studying across 6 campuses. And this makes us South Australia's largest university. Each of our campuses have purpose-built facilities to accompany the degree that you're studying there. So our City West campus focuses on business, law, art, architecture, and design degrees, whereas our City East campus focuses on all things health. Our McGill campus is where you'll find our creative students studying film and TV, journalism, and visual effects, as well as our psychology, social work, and some of our education students. At Mawson Lakes, that's where you'll find our STEM team. So you'll find students there studying aviation, engineering, information technology, and also some education students there too. In addition, we have campuses at Mount Gambier and Whyalla, and they focus on offerings with the greatest need for those regions. So that includes nursing, social work, and education. We also offer 100% online degrees through UniSA Online, and that gives students the flexibility to study with us from wherever they're located. The important thing to note is that once you're a UniSA student, you will have access to all of our campus facilities, regardless of which campus your degree is based at. Perfect. So let's get stuck into how to get into university. We're going to spend the next few slides elaborating on some entry methods for you. But the first step is really to decide whether you feel ready to start or whether you prefer a more supported pathway to university study. I'm going to talk you through some of our more direct pathways, and then Amelia will give you some information about some really supported pathways that are available through UniSA College. So let's begin. Let's talk about TAFE to begin with. So depending on the degree, you can use TAFE study as an entry method for a UniSA degree, and you may even qualify for guaranteed entry. You just need to upload your TAFE qualifications as part of your SATAC application. That's the South Australian Tertiary Admission Centre, and they're the people who process all of our applications. So you can see entry requirements on each of our degree web pages, and it's a good idea to check there to see what level of TAFE study would make you eligible for study for a particular degree. And if you're not sure or want some help, you can give our Future Student Inquiries team a call. They will be happy to help you. As I said, you might be eligible for some credit, and you can check the credit assessor on our webpage. Credit applications are made once you've been accepted into the degree. If you're studying with TAFE right now, you can still start your SATAC application. This will allow a SATAC to start initial checks, and you can avoid SATAC's late fees. You just upload your diploma or certificate for later in the year once it's complete. And we'll talk a little bit more about SATAC applications in some upcoming slides. So let's talk about the Special Tertiary Admission Test. The STAT is a great option for people who feel ready to study but don't have a direct entry method. It is an online test of literacy, numeracy, and problem-solving skills, and it gives you a score which you can use to apply for any UniSA degree. There's no need to wait for your score to begin your SATAC application. You can start now and upload it later. STATs are booked online through ASA, and you book 1 week before the test opens, and then you get your results 2 weeks after you've taken it. And the next test is scheduled for mid-November. We recommend visiting the STAT webpage because you can download a brochure there that has heaps of information, but also some practice questions, which are a good way to prepare. Lastly, let's talk about tertiary transfer. So most people know that you can use a GPA from a previous university study as an entry method on your SATAC application. A GPA is a grade point average. You can also use a GPA from current university study, even if you haven't finished your degree yet. So you can use your GPA as soon as you've done 4 courses from any particular degree. If you've done fewer than 2 years of university study altogether, you can also use previous entry methods, such as an ATAR. And if you have more than one entry method, SATAC will automatically choose the most competitive method for you. They're good like that. So if you're a current UniSA student, you might also be able to apply for an internal transfer, and we would recommend chatting to Campus Central about that. But students from other universities are going to apply via SATAC. And as I said, we'll talk a little bit more about your SATAC application later. So thank you for listening to me talk about direct pathways. Amelia is going to talk to you now about some options with UniSA College. Thank you.
Thanks, Jen. So UniSA College offers pathways for people who either don't have an ATAR or don't have an ATAR that's competitive enough to get them into their preferred degree. So UniSA College is part of UniSA, but it's designed to prepare students for success at university. So through the college, we offer 4 types of programs. So they are foundation studies, diplomas, the undergraduate certificate in university studies, and the Aboriginal Pathway program. So all of the programs have the same goals: to prepare students with the academic skills they need to feel confident and ready to embark on a bachelor degree. But one thing to note about our college programs is that they are only open to domestic students. So that's Australian citizens, permanent residents, or humanitarian visa holders. So there are a few pathway options that will get you into a UniSA bachelor's degree. So they're just displayed here on the slide. So if you don't do as well in year 12 as you'd hoped, and you don't have an ATAR, you can apply for UniSA Foundation Studies, which is 6 months long. So this will provide you with the foundational skills you need to prepare you for uni study. After completing foundation studies, you can then progress either directly into an undergraduate certificate in university studies, which is 6 months long, or a diploma, which is 12 months long. So the main difference is that the undergraduate certificate gives you access to around 90% of UniSA bachelor degrees, whereas the diplomas give you access to 100% of UniSA bachelor degrees. So if you're in year 12 and you do get an ATAR, but it's not enough to get you into your preferred degree, you can actually skip foundation studies altogether and go straight into a diploma. So for this, you'll need a selection rank of 50 or above, or a STAT test score of 139 or higher, or a certificate 3 or 4. And our last option is the Aboriginal Pathway Program. So this is available to students who identify as Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander, but these students can actually apply for any of the college programs that we offer. So the Aboriginal Pathway Program is 18 months long, and it gives you access to any UniSA bachelor degree upon completion. So now I'm going to go into a few of these programs in a little bit more detail. So UniSA Foundation Studies is a fee-free program. It's designed to give you the skills you need to excel at university study. So it's 6 months long, full-time. It's offered on campus at City West, Mount Gambier or Whyalla, or you can study it externally online. So you can apply for Foundation Studies through SATAC. You can include it as one of your preferences. Even if you're quite confident that you will get into your preferred degree, I would still recommend listing Foundation Studies as one of your lower preferences. That way you're just ensured that you'll get into university regardless. After completing Foundation Studies, you can then progress straight into either an undergraduate certificate, as I mentioned, or a diploma internally. So you won't have to apply via SATAC again. So some of the benefits of Foundation Studies are that you don't need an ATAR to get in. It teaches you the skills you need for uni study, so skills like academic writing, research and study skills, referencing. And after successfully completing Foundation Studies, you have guaranteed entry into either the undergraduate certificate or a diploma. So now moving on to our undergraduate certificate in university studies. So this program allows you to explore courses aligned to your area of interest while you build your grade point average to use as an entry method into your degree. So our undergraduate certificates are 6 months long, full time. You can choose from six specializations in business, creative studies, education studies, health, social sciences, and STEM. The undergraduate certificates are only available to UniSA students who have completed Foundation Studies. So you can't apply for the undergraduate certificate through SATAC. And once you've completed the undergraduate certificates, you can apply for entry into most UniSA bachelor degrees, but not all. So it is a good idea to check your pathway options with our Future Student Inquiries team before you make your choices. Moving on to our diplomas. So UniSA College diplomas provide entry into all UniSA bachelor degrees. So you can either transfer into a diploma after completing Foundation Studies, or if you have an ATAR of over 50, you can skip Foundation Studies and get straight into a diploma. So you can include any of our diplomas as a preference in your SATAC application. So it's a really good backup option to include. Our diplomas are 12 months long, full time. You can choose from 21 specializations across a wide range of study areas. So this will give you real insight into your preferred degree. And the other great thing is that you can gain up to 2 course credits towards a related bachelor degree through your diploma. So once you've completed your diploma, you have a diploma qualification. And from there, you can transfer internally into any UniSA bachelor degree using your competitive GPA. And our last college program that I'm going to talk about is our Aboriginal Pathway Program. So as I mentioned, this is available to anybody who identifies as Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander, though they can apply for any UniSA college program. The Aboriginal Pathway Program is a free 1.5-year program. It's designed to prepare Aboriginal students for university study. So it's similar to Foundation Studies in that it teaches you the skills you need for uni study, but it also includes courses on Aboriginal culture and well-being, the community and the environment. So the Aboriginal Pathway is taught across 5 locations at our City West campus and also regionally in Ceduna, Mount Gambier, Port Lincoln and Whyalla. So through the Aboriginal Pathway program, you will have access to smaller class sizes and a lot of one-on-one support from your teachers. And after completing the program, students can use their competitive GPA to apply for entry into any UniSA bachelor degree. So the purpose of UniSA college programs is to equip you with the tools that you need to succeed into your chosen bachelor degree and beyond. So you'll receive continuous support from the UniSA college staff throughout the whole process through things like one-on-one sessions for enrollment support, academic consultations and tailored study plans, So listed on this slide here are just some examples of the kind of support you receive as a UniSA College student. So basically, we're here to make sure you feel really supported from the start with orientation and enrollment through your program and all the way through to your bachelor degree. So as a UniSA College student, you are a UniSA student, so you'll have access to all the same services as any other student, but you will get that additional support to help you transition into uni life. And now I'm going to hand back over to Jen to talk about next steps and how to apply.
Thank you so much. Okay, hopefully by now you have an idea of what entry pathway is going to be most suitable for you. And remember, if you're not sure, you can give our Future Student Inquiries team a call. We're happy to help you work it out. The next step is to think about your SATAC application. So whatever pathway you choose, your next step is to make your SATAC application if you haven't already. And you're going to do that by applying online at satac.edu.au. When you make your SATAC application, you can choose up to 6 preferences. So we recommend you order your preferences in order of passion. So that means putting the thing you want to study most first. And again, if you're not sure, we're happy to help you at Future Student Inquiries work out what order that is. We would definitely recommend thinking about putting some backup options on your application, and UniSA College programs make great backups, foundation studies or a diploma. So you can go back into your application and reorder your preferences after you have submitted. So don't let not being sure stop you applying. You can still make changes. You will want to check if there are any prerequisites or additional requirements before you complete your application. So for example, if you're applying for an education degree, you'd need to submit something called a teaching capability statement with your application. You'll need to submit any required documentation. For example, if you've got a certificate 4 that you're using to apply, you might want to upload that with your application. And it's important to note that your application won't be complete until you've paid your fees. We would recommend getting your application complete before the 29th of September, because it's a lot cheaper right now than it will be in the rest of the year. The fees go up at that point. So there you go, 5 easy steps. In terms of your timeline for all of this, well, SATAC applications are open right now. And as I mentioned, the early closing date is the 29th of September. You can still apply after that. Your application fee for SATAC will just be a little bit higher. There will be some early offer rounds between October and December. Now, we don't know in advance which degrees will release early offers, so don't panic if you've made an application and you haven't heard anything yet. You're most likely to hear in December or January. The change of preference deadline is the 3rd of January, and that's the date by which you need to have finished switching your preferences around. So we recommend that you have your preferences in the order you want them before this date. The main offer round is going to be on the 11th of January. And orientation and classes start in late February. Now, once you do get an offer, you'll get an email from SATAC letting you know, and then you'll get an email from our Campus Central team at UniSA a couple of days later letting you know how to enroll in your classes. We would recommend enrolling as soon as possible so that you get the timetable that suits you. Definitely, if you are applying for a high demand program, do double check what your enroll by date is, because you don't want to lose your place if you don't enroll in time. So we thought we'd take a minute now to talk to you about the kind of support services that are available at UniSA for all UniSA students. We're actually ranked number 1 in South Australia for our support services, so we're well known for the range of support that we offer to our students. In helping students transition to university, we offer support such as a UniSA Ready module, and that teaches our students about campus information and student conduct, connecting with staff, and also balancing work life and study, which can be a bit tricky sometimes. We have a Uni Mentor program, and that partners new students with more experienced current students as a mentor. Also, our academic learning support team are on hand to provide advice regarding assignments, referencing, study skills, quizzes and exams, and similar things. We also have a career services team, and they're available to help you with anything career related. So CV writing, finding jobs, and connecting students with employers through career events and expos. There's some fun stuff at UniSA that you should check out too. You can get involved in much more beyond your standard classes. Students can choose electives that allow you to complete placements and internships with our industry partners. From the second year, students can also go on an overseas study tour or an exchange. And for a bit of fun, we have over 80 different clubs and societies and over 25 sporting clubs. So we definitely recommend finding a group of people to hang out with and make friends with. So there you go. Thank you so much for listening to Amelia and myself talk to you about pathways. We thought it might be useful for you to hear from a current UniSA student. So we've invited Sophia to come along and have a chat with you.
Hi, everyone.
Hello, thanks for coming. Me? What are you studying with UniSA, Sophia?
I'm actually in my third year of psychology honours.
Fantastic. Well done. How's it going?
That's very good. We're in stressful exam season right now, so just preparing for that.
Can you tell us what kind of study support you found useful while you've been studying?
Yeah, definitely. So throughout this year, I've definitely been in contact with our amazing learning advisors who have helped me get some assessments done. Also, our past sessions are very valuable. So the peer assisted study sessions, so they actually run by students who have completed certain courses and have excelled in them. They've come back to teach that to current students, which is amazing. Also, our USASA wellbeing events that are run throughout the year, they are very useful, especially during exam season. Often they give out free food and study advice, so definitely enjoy those.
Fantastic. What have you found most challenging?
I think sometimes it's just that motivation to study. It's quite normal for a lot of students to get through that, but support services are great. So
fantastic. And what do you find most rewarding about your degree?
I think the involvement with different students. So I love attending all the student events that are hosted throughout the year. Volunteering is a huge part of university life as well. So I've been able to help out on our amazing campus fairs as well as open day.
Fantastic. Thank you so much. Could we ask you for three tips for a first year student?
All right. So the first tip I would say is volunteer and join as many student clubs as possible. It's a great way to make friends and also network with like-minded people. Number two, I would say go up and speak and connect with your tutors and professors. Often these people are experts in their respective field and have a wealth of knowledge, and they're always happy to have a chat. The final tip would be working out the best way that you study. So focusing on those different study techniques early on, just so you understand how to manage your time around exam season.
Those are great tips. Thank you so much for coming along today.
Thank you for having me.
So we thought we'd take a moment to let you know how you can explore a UniSA campus. We do have some campus tours coming up in October. They fill up fast, so if you would like to register for one, I would recommend getting online and making a registration. If you're interstate or just very busy and you're not able to make a campus tour, you can also check out a virtual campus tour online at any time. This webinar is one of a series. We hope you've enjoyed this one. We do have two more coming up. Next week, we have a Fast Track Your Degree with UniSA's Accelerate webinar. And in December, we will be running What to Expect in Your First Year at UniSA. And all our webinars are recorded, so you can jump online at any time and watch some of our previous webinars too, if you think that might be useful. And that's really all we had to say to you today. We hope that you found the presentation helpful and are feeling a bit more confident about your pathway options into UniSA. If you have questions later, please feel free to give our Future Student Inquiries team a call. You can see the number on the screen there. But if you've got questions right now, please feel free to jump into the Q&A, and Elise is ready and waiting to answer your questions. We'll hang on for a moment just to see what questions you've got. Thanks again for coming.